How's it going, everyone? This is Maya Hello, and welcome to another bonus video of Kingdom Hearts Blind. This should be bonus video number 3, unless things go horribly wrong, which they could go horribly wrong. So I just want to check something that I noticed off screen when I was here. There's like this blue jar that I never really examined. Orichalcum. Nice. That's it. Can I break it? I can't break it. Well, that's fine. I wonder what kind of pattern it has. Nothing too much, I guess. It's just purple and it has one eye, so... Actually, I'm curious. What happens if I... put all these torches out? Is there any sort of secret behind that? I wonder. Now I'm stupidly curious. Okay, so I heard something. Oh, there's a treasure chest. Look at that. All these secrets that I never bothered to find. Only a gummy ship. Who cares about that? I don't fly with the gummy ship anymore. I warp drive is the new fad. You know, so what is the point of this video? The point of this video is for me to take on the gold match of the Colosseum. Is this game running slower now? Do I have too much data on here? Well, man, I've been playing this game for about 60 hours. Maybe not 60 hours in video, since a lot of time is spent like with off-screen and... Sora looks transparent. Notice, look at that. You can see like the column behind, or like the wall behind him. That's interesting. Alright, so I'm gonna be taking on the Ice Titan in the gold match today. I received some conflicting advice. Someone told me that maybe I should use Arrow. And maybe that's true, maybe I could use Arrow, but I was also advised against using Eroga. So with that in mind, I guess I'm gonna equip Fyraga since, you know, ice. So might as well melt it. So that's kinda like why I also gave Sora the Holy Circlet, which is what I had on him before. I mean, the new thing that he got was... Did we get anything new in the last video? I mean, maybe the XP ring, I think? That's the new thing I created? Oh dear. Oh, I just created like a mithril stone, right. Actually, I wonder if there's anything... What is this heart guard? Ooh. Looks intriguing. But... I just want to be precautious and protect against ice. So... Let's do it. Let's die. So... I may need some time to figure out how to fight this boss, because I'm going in blind. Some of you have offered detailed explanations, but I'm going to figure this out on my own. People say this shouldn't be too hard of a super boss. That being said, I still want to be cautious enough. So, gold match, Ice Titan. Can I... Okay, that hurts. Oh, interesting. So, guarding is the main key here. Interesting. I never expected to use that.
You're very lucky.
I never expected to have to use this.
You're very lucky.
That's a quote from Star Fox. Not a quote from Star Fox. Am I doing this right? Well, maybe I should avoid these stalagmites, icicles. I mean, I think the mnemonic for stalagmites versus stalactites is G for ground, C for ceiling, so that's my mnemonic. Oh! Alright, I think I'm getting the hang of this, maybe. I mean, I did try to avoid advice, but at the same time, I think I kind of wasn't able to avoid most advice. Come on! Also, I'm alone. I mean, that's kind of a similar situation with the Sephiroth fight that I have ahead of me, where... Oh, what happened? Oh. You're mine! It's a shame I can't use something like... maybe I could have done Ars Arcana Mania, but he was like too high. So much ice! Ice to meet you! Get up, Sora, get up. Jesus Christmas! Heal, 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 heal. Maybe you should also target... Wow, this guy is not kidding around. It's kind of like my strategy of like healing when I'm getting attacked, since if I have Leaf Bracer on, then this... Okay, I can't actually see anything that's going on. Move. Constant movement. Constant vigilance. Maybe I can actually use these stands for support. That would be a good idea. Ow, ow, ow. Well... This is a thing. So not much is going on aside from... Well, maybe I shouldn't glide. I guess it's going to be important to know your timing of everything, like the super guard. Maybe you should also learn the attacks that he's doing as well. Like, know like when he's telegraphing the attacks. Like that. Know when he's doing that. Oh. I think, that's pretty much, I think, going to be key. Know when he's doing certain attacks. And know how to react to certain attacks. Jeez. And not slip on ice either, Sora. Mayo. Fireaga has no effect. Good to know. So this is kind of gimmicky, if I'm to be real. Quite unlike most boss fights in this game. Like, it plays by its own rules, apparently. It seems like. Get up. Don't slip on the ice. Oh, come on. Okay. I'm not doing well at all. This is also not very interesting to watch, huh? Maybe I should time this better too, you think? There we go. I mean, this is a unique boss fight in that you kind of have to do, like, more careful strategies. Or, know how to use guard effectively. Or, I guess if you're not using guard, you might use, like... just slashing those missiles back at him, I think. Yeah, I think, like... I was given advice, even though I tried to ignore it, but I did hear some stuff about the missiles, so... I think that's kind of, like, why I'm instinctively being... doing this as well. So, this is a bad camera angle to fight him with, actually. Well, this is... I can certainly say this is not as easy as Rock Titan. So, good on you, Ice Titan. You're actually somewhat of a challenge, maybe. Mostly because it seems like you're invincible when we're not playing this game. Well, I guess you're invincible when you are playing this game of yours. Maybe I should have... Did I equip enough Air Combo Pluses? Maybe not. Maybe I didn't equip the Air Combo Pluses. If not, then that's going to be a shame. Heal, 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 heal. That was a bad time to do that. Careful. Alright, so this just takes a long time. Don't die, don't die, don't die, don't die. I actually have to wonder though, so this is pretty much reflecting stuff back at the boss. If that's the case, why would people advise against Iroga? I mean, I don't want to experiment now, since if that means I may screw things up. No, 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 no! Jeez.
Come on!
Okay, that was a bit of a blooper that shouldn't have happened, but... I mean, at least I still got out of it. Actually, I know, like, a friend of mine who speedruns Kingdom Hearts, sometimes he actually does press the PlayStation button during the gummy ship portions to kind of help speed them up, I guess? Like, less... less control, so... Oh, Sora. You're like, Did he break off his own legs off his feet? Did you see that? Like, his feet are actually... Oh, God. Yes, his feet are actually... Oh, God. Alright. Missiles. So... Yeah, if I were to say anything about this boss fight, it's just that it's... kind of bordering on tedious more than anything. Like, nothing too special, just, you know. Then again, I probably could guard better. I know, my timing is off. I know. Jeez, Mayo, your timing's off. There we go, that's something better to do. I mean, I can't seem to reflect all of them at once. Now. Alright, go. This is your chance, do it. Oh, this is too slow. This is going a bit slowly, but fine. Oh, jeez. I mean, I would stand in place and guard to hit those back at him, but there's like a ton of shit going into my face. So, I have to be a little careful. Well, careful as in I have to also guard better too. So, oh. It's like either you guard or you get hit. Well, okay, I got hit there because that was stupid. This should be painful to watch, I know. Wow, my timing is horrible. Did I ever mention that I'm terrible at timing-based games? Okay, that was productive. Alright, so I'm kind of back to where I was before. Maybe, if I don't die here. So I've kind of... started to understand how this boss works. It's more like I'm starting to understand how I should act in certain portions of this fight. Obviously, I'm doing better if I'm not talking, but yeah, so I decided to read Katarina's comment. Thank you, Katarina, for your comment and help. But I think Katarina said, oh, why'd you jump? So, Katarina said the reason why Aroga or Arrow can be bad is because Ice Titan will then use larger ice missiles, which will be difficult to deflect compared to these ones. So, that's why. So, I think, like, Aroga might be a case of a trade-off. Like, I would have an easier time deflecting these ice missiles since Aroga automatically reflects projectiles back at the enemies. But, the problem is, would it be worth having like stronger missiles to fight against? Who knows? So I think that's part of the issue here, so... There we go. Alright, now he's vulnerable again. I guess in retrospect, I should have equipped Berserk on Sora as well, since there's one point when I was slashing at his face and I was almost dying, so I think that would have helped me out. I think what would actually help me out is having a stronger weapon as well. Because there's no doubt that this guy has a lot of health. Okay, I think that's how I died the first time. Okay, just, I think right now is the time to keep on moving and healing. Dodgy ice breath. Don't slip. Actually, that's a move that he is kind of doing more as... Yeah, that's a Pissy Boss mode move. Okay. It kind of reminds me of that one move that one of the final bosses in Twilight Princess does. The one involving like a Triforce appearing at the ground. So with that description, you should know what I'm talking about. It's in the first phase, actually, where like the entire boss fight is easy. You know, the boss shoots projectiles at you, but then if you're on the ground when the boss does the super attack, you know, on the ground, then you get massive damage. Then again, it's Twilight Princess, so there's no such thing as massive damage unless you're doing like the hero mode. Yeah, that's the attack that Ice didn't use on me to kill me the last time. It was like, it happened all of a sudden and out of nowhere. Now I understand why. It's like the super move that's like a lot of area and it's sudden. I thought like his ice breath attack was the one that killed me. But it's actually this one, where it's like, freeze. Maybe I could have used an ether, but I mean elixir, but I think I'm fine with this setup since I'm actually getting a good amount of MP back at a good rate since. So I think part of it is because I'm getting MP back because of MP Rage, which gives me back MP whenever I get hit, so that helps. Okay, he's doing that again. No. What?
I give up.
Oh, Sora, don't give up. Because then I will give up. And you know how much of a quitter I am. Probably more of a quitter than you are. Did you know? I'm a quitter, but I'm not gonna give up. Because I can teach this scrawny bitch a lesson to not give up. So basically that monologue made no sense. I'm getting worse. Thank you. How do you dodge that attack anyway? So, I suppose I should come back to... No, really, how do you dodge that attack? Is it just the benefit of me just being in a terrible position to begin with? Because... He's been able to hit me all the time this time. Also, you may notice that I have, like... So, I equipped 3 tech boosts on myself because I wanted to get more experience out of this battle from each block that I do. So, might as well get grinds of experience while I'm here. Alright, there we go. That's how you dodge, in theory. Okay, now's my chance to get him again. Almost. Oh, don't screw it up, Sora. No. Alright, I would deflect here, but those giant ice cubes of death are like coming down on my face. Alright. I may not be talking much, but I want to focus a little bit, because I need to focus in this battle. This battle is definitely harder than what I've seen before in the game. There we go. So may notice that I have more HP. That's because I leveled up in the middle of the battle, so that's a relief. Okay, that makes sense. Wherever he faces, that's where the ice of death will happen. Oh, don't stop. There we go. That's a lot of experience that I got. I should be getting a lot of experience from this battle. I think the thing is, like, psychologically, I want to stay in a certain angle from him, just because it's what I'm used to. Then again, he'll be doing that. But he's also, like, that was a corner that I wasn't occupying. Oh, I'm doing worse now that I'm talking. Did I kill him? Oh! I did it! I was like... Oh! Now, if this game were rated M for mature, we would have seen death. I'm actually disappointed that we didn't get to see death, like him crushing that ice height into bits. Do I not get an Ansem's report from that? I thought you get Ansem's reports from... Oh. Okay. What is this diamond dust that I just got? Oath... I have to make sure, like, Oath... Divine Rose was the good one, right? Yeah. Oh, geez, look at that strength decrease, but look at that MP increase. So, it would have been super amazing with that pink Agarius thing, I guess. And I guess... I mean... This will give me the most amount of MP ever. Okay. I guess I have to wonder, how many more, Ansem's journals do I have left? I don't know. Well, I guess... Oh, we finished this! Oh. Defeated once by Hercules, received new powers from Hades... Yeah, like... Wait. He appeared twice in Hercules, or... Oh, maybe, like, received new powers in this game. Well, I mean, I thought about using fire on him, but maybe I could have used fire on him whenever he went down, instead of, like, trying to do air combos. Hindsight is 20/20. That would have made the fight a little easier, but I was too focused on just fighting. Alright, so that means we should get more entries in Characters 1 and The Heartless. I'm a little concerned about these two. Will they be more super bosses, or am I actually missing more Heartless? I mean, I guess I'll see when I do more item synthesis. What I should do is find like a game facts guide of like all of the Heartless in Jiminy's Journal and Kingdom Hearts Final Mix, because Final Mix has quite a lot of differences from the original version, or Kingdom Hearts Vanilla, as some people say. Yeah, so I think that's it for this video. Nice! So, it was something I was wondering about. Like, whenever I fight alone, do Donald and Goofy level up with me? And the answer is they do. I'm pretty tempted to just stay here and grind, since... Then again, it's kind of a rough battle. So I don't know, is Ice Titan a good grinding fight? There's a part of me that says, hell no, but there's a part of me that says, well, you kind of optimized experience grinding from Ice Titan, so might as well do it again, right? It's tempting. But yeah, that was Ice Titan. I don't know if I'll go on with the other super bosses. It depends on, because like, I was able to defeat Ice Titan without the ultimate weapon from the item synthesis side quest at level 63 up to 64. The extra HP, I think, helped. But yeah, thanks for watching, and goodbye.